Okay, so this is probably going to be a long video, but this is the Forbidden Grove. And what we have here is the Water Heart puzzle. So, a little bit longer. We do have to go through a side area in order to unlock the Water Heart. We're gonna unlock this door. I've already gone through on the other side. But our first little tidbit is to go down this ladder. Wade water over the back side of this. We're gonna find a chest. Waterfall secrets. Doesn't everyone love them? Chest. Right here, underneath the checkpoint. Second bit down here. Going straight across from where the ladder was. Into that little cave over there. There are some enemies. Make sure you don't get too close, because we are in an area where we can't dodge. Alright, once you clear all these guys out, we have another chest over here in the Forbidden Grove by the Water Heart puzzle. We go down our ladder through the cave. There's our second chest. And Blood Jewel. On the Blood Jewel, charge melee attacks, apply bleeding, dealing 598 bleed damage over 20 seconds. Alright. So, in order to power up the Water Harp, we have to go to another area, which is right behind this area. And in case anyone didn't know, there is another chest over here. There's our checkpoint. We're gonna walk to the Water Heart. We're gonna go up the stairs. And as you would continue going up the stairs, you just go straight around here. There's another chest. Already got that earlier. We're gonna go power up this Water Heart. And we have the Faithless Thicket. Okay. Let's walk through the Faithless Thicket. I really don't like roly-polies. Up here for materials. We got one. That's good. Go get that until hopefully he drops some Luminite. Heart of the Wolf. This can be a random of any type. Nyesha. Luminite, a glitch through the floor. Lovely. Got a chest here. Got a nice iron. I don't think there's much here if I remember correctly. But if I recognize it, I'll point it out. Thank you. Yeah, so there's not really much in the way of secrets here. Let's walk through to get to where we need to go. Pretty sure there's a trait point here though somewhere. Didn't look over there. My trait points are maxed out, but trait points still give you experience, which I am trying to level up all the archetypes. I didn't get a trait point in this one. Unless it's off in the other direction. Might be here too. Oh. Okay, so this is our main way through anyways to get to the water harp. You can tell by the square door and exclamation mark. Side areas will have a round door and an open diamond. This is the nameless enough. And we have the tower. Tower secret and the nameless nest. So, we'll go through that secret. Kind of nice. Pretty sure there's an elite around here, so I'm gonna try to take care of that, and then we'll go through the tower. I actually don't have one. Okay, so In the tower, basically what we want to do is we want to go up the elevator first, because there is something to get up here. Got this little chest. There is a ring that drops from there. Gonna go back down. And then what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna activate the elevator. You'll notice we have symbols you can take a step back. And take a look at all the symbols. We have 4 symbols. No puzzle. Basically, wanna walk through this. It has to be in order. Anywho, we have this and a heart. This will net you the blooming heart, which I'll go ahead and show for a second here. On use, heals 35% of max health. Over 5 seconds, spawns 3 healing orbs, which grant 35% health of the caster's health. For 5 seconds, orbs last 20 seconds. Recasting removes previous orbs. Not bad. I already have it, so we get rid of this. Anyways, that's the tower secret. Moving along. Got a trait point.
Carry any more of that.
And our purple. Guardian ring. Can be any random ring that you have, or that can appear in Yasha. I could scrap that. This boss, pretty easy in my opinion. But basically, it's a big flyer. He's gonna slash down, try to dodge that. He also spurts out spore pods. And you wanna kinda look up to see where they're gonna land. Make sure you're not in that puddle because it does a lot of damage per second. Then when he slams down, you want to go ahead and get onto the next platform. hollowed egg from that. This door, and then the next path out should be the water harp. Look at that. That is messed up. 5-0, 4-0. So that raises the bridge. And we have one more song to play. Okay, so the next song, we're gonna do one, 4, 0, 2, 5, 0, 3. Zero. This gives us a secret weapon called the Bolt Driver. And past this, What we want to do is we want to talk to the flautist. The flautist will give us a material for a weapon mod. But yeah, that is the water harp. This gives us a weapon mod for support healing. Hey, this is the Ravager. And the Doe. Once we get to this point, you have a couple of options. You can shoot the Ravager. Doing so will get you Ursula's Lawn Gun. You can revive the Doe, which you will also have to fight the Ravager. That gives you the Red Doe Staff. And the version that I'm going to do this time will net me an amulet that increases damage to bleeding targets. It's the only version that I haven't done yet. So, fortunately, you're not going to see the Ravager fight, but those are the three options. So we can shoot the Ravager, get the Merciless Long Gun. We can revive the Doe, get the Red Doe Staff, as you see on my back here. Or we can shoot the Doe and get an amulet. This allows you to skip the fight, though. All damage dealt to bleeding targets bonus increases 30% with 50% of it. So,